this is my new VR camera rig. And this is also my new VR camera rig, the Travel Edition. It can also turn on its own to take 360 virtual tour photo. How cool is that? Today, we are going to review the brand new Zhiyun WeeBill 3S, aka the Darth Vader, and its little stormtrooper brother, the Crane M3S. And I'm gonna give away one of the brand new WeeBill 3S right here.
What?
Watch till the end and see how. In this video, we will cover what's new compared to the previous generation of WeeBill 3 and Crane M3. What is that S? What does it stand for?
Social Media Mode.
Kimchi with Zhiyun S Gimbal.
Battle has begun! Fight!
He's too fast! Oh, you really... I don't know about this, but
this video will help you decide if you need this gimbal or not by showing you all the strengths and weaknesses. For traditional 2D filmmakers, vertical social media creators, immersive VR 180 filmmakers, and realistic virtual tour creators. We will also teach you how to connect your camera with the wireless Bluetooth shutter trigger, the key new feature that took me a while to figure out on my Sony Alpha camera. Oh, and my Frankenstein one-man lighting plus camera mobile setup. And yes, this little gimbal can use as a motorized panel head like the famous Nodal Ninja Mega, but better with 1000 lux built-in soft light so you can capture professional quality 14K 60 photos like this one with two kimchi in it. Let's go! Hey, what's up everybody? It's your boy Hugh here. Zhiyun just released two new updated gimbal on their most popular model, the WeeBill and the Crane M, based on their user feedback over the past year. Let's see what has changed. The butt and the undersling are still here. Zhiyun did not give up their ergonomic design because it's good for long hours and low angle shooting. But if you hate it, now you have the option to take them off with a simple quick release. Now, it is just a regular gimbal, very lightweight, and you can carry it with only one hand easily. The gimbal butt right here, now it is a lot softer, made with high quality material instead of the plastic like the old WeeBill 3. It also has this knob right here to adjust the angle of the butt to make it sit nicely on different body types and different camera angle. The undersling can now be adjust angle like this, from sling grip to two-handed grip. I definitely prefer the two-handed grip a lot more, as in VR 1D filming, we don't do super low angle. It makes people sick. The undersling bar now is found in the center of gravity. I can easily run with the heavy camera in sport mode undersling, like right here, chasing kimchi. But you still see noticeable vibration and shaking when you run really fast. I hope the next firmware update can make the running gimbal shot smoother. But to be fair, DJI RF3 also has this issue. That is why there is an easy rig or other support system to remove that up and down vibration. It finally has Bluetooth shutter control, just like the DJI RS3 Mini. This frees up the USB-C port from the Canon camera, so now we can charge it to enable 8K 60 frames per second raw shooting mode, but still have the camera control using Bluetooth. It still has that built-in field light with 1000 lux, but they get rid of the built-in microphone. Sidebar here, I'm one of those solo creators, really appreciate the built-in high quality field light. Now, the end of the undersling right here also allows you to attach more light onto the setup like this, and it still keeps it light and minimum. Take a look at a low budget solo virtual tour filming example when you have no control in the environment lighting. You see the differences with works without light. You see Kitty's eye line right here. The little field light on the WeeBill 3S create a light in her eye, which make her look more alive compared to the one without. It is a subtle differences, but it is essential to convey emotion. The biggest update of all, it is the native portrait shooting mode for TikTok, YouTube Short, and IG Reel, like right here. The only other gimbal can really do that is the DJI RS 3 Mini. Is it a good design though? Well, questionable. It takes time to rebalance from horizontal to vertical mode, and this little connection clamp right here is what holds the entire vertical camera setup, and it is hella hard to move it around to find the balance point. If you only shoot vertical video the whole day, yes, it is a pretty dope design, but most of the videographers out there are hybrid. Each time to switch from horizontal to vertical will take like 10 minutes to rebalance everything. If you work with the real clients, time is money. I think my Unite Z Velcam half K setup right here is a way better solution. You can balance on a horizontal mode and just turn it into vertical mode in a second when needed. And it works with any heavy duty gimbal that with cell correction, like the DJI RS3 or the heavy-duty Zhiyun Crane M3S. So TikToker, I'm not so sure you need this. But TikTokers, don't run away just yet. You might need the Crane M3S, which is designed for mobile creators who want to level up their image quality with a full-frame camera like the Sony Alpha 7 series right here or the Canon R5. Let me quickly show you two ways how to switch from horizontal to vertical shooting mode in less than 1 second. First, I always have, to show you, 1-4 screw mount right here. I always have a tripod leg just mounting right here. So I always have like 2 points. So make sure that my gimbal is super smooth, super stable. 2-point grabbing, 2-point off contact. And then from there, right here, I hold down the trigger button right here to go in gold mode. Hold down it and just flip it slowly. Double tap again, recenter. Now we are in social media vertical filming. Look at that. Great, right? So when you're done, hold on trigger button, toggle trigger button again, go into go mode, flip, double tap. Now you're back to normal filming. Great, right? The only downside of this method is the joystick is swapped. Up and down is left and left and right is up and down. Method 2 is the official way. You use the touchscreen to go into mode, portrait mode, the camera will point up, then drop your camera like this to film vertically. You don't need to hold your gimbal sideways. You can turn the tripod part down and let the weight sit on your hand like so for an easier handling. In this mode, if you hold down the trigger button, it will become all locked mode, which is great for tracking shot moving forward and backward. I like my method 1 better because it is a lot faster without touching any menu. What do you think? If you like this extra tip, don't forget to drop me a like, and if you are new here, please consider following us. It will help us a lot to continue providing free knowledge and research for you. You can also film vertically like that on the older version of the Crane M3. So what is the benefit of buying the new one? Well, if you have the Crane M3, then you actually do not really need to upgrade. They are mostly the same. M3S actually 5G heavier than the M3 and half an hour less battery than the M3. But it has a built-in Bluetooth shutter and get rid of the extra Bluetooth module on the base, so it's end up lighter. Bluetooth shutter control is also the key to take 360 photo for virtual tour. More on that later. The M3S also has a new locking mechanism. Now my whole system is locked, but hear it? It still shakes for some reason. the M3S has a more powerful field light with 1000 lux this time. The quick release is different as well, now to support heavier camera combo. The motor is also improved and more powerful now. It will fit my Sony Alpha 1 with the Sony FEPC 16-35mm. It will also fit my Panasonic GH6 with a heavier Olympus lens. It will even fit my Canon R5. If you have a camera that you want me to test, comment below. So, who will benefit most for this gimbal? Social media content creators, vertical shooters, and travel vloggers will definitely benefit from upgrading to a full-frame sensor camera with the Zhiyun Crane M3S, as I mentioned above, especially if you are new to the gimbal or a beginner. The LED screen helps you to figure out your balance, as you see right here. My camera is actually not balanced right now. It will also unlock creative shots that you wouldn't be able to do without a gimbal, like the Vortex Mode right here. What about WeeBill 3S right here? For professional videographers or cinematographers who use heavy camera like here, the Canon C70 with a heavy cinema lens, or you need to run to chase a talent like Kimchi by Shiba Ninyu, then the Zhiyun WeeBill 3S is still not I would recommend. WeeBill 3S can handle very heavy camera. The problem is not the payload, but the accessory ecosystem for Steadicam operators. Tutor, for example, a accessory brand for DJI gimbal, built this ring grip for RS3, which is necessary to mount this whole system onto an Easy Rig Mini Max. If you need to film a car, you will need the Tudor Hydra Alien card mounting system, and they only support the DJI gimbal, not Zhiyun, unfortunately. If you plan to outgrow social media content creation and take on real commercial client to make real money, then I will suggest investing a ecosystem that has a broader professional rigging support, but with exception, like the VR180 filmmakers or virtual tour creators, our community of special creators who shoot with the Canon R5 or the R5C with the dual Fisheye lens. As you see right here, in order to get the DJI Play out of the way, you will need all this heavy setup. Offset V-Log battery to balance your R5 or R5C on the DJI gimbal. It works, but it is heavy and you definitely cannot do under sling with this heavy setup. On the other hand, WeeBill 3S fit the Canon R5C perfectly without any extra weight, and you can use the V-mount clamp to mount the V-mount battery on the sling handle, which can provide PD fast charging to the Canon R5C for 60 frame 8K raw capture, or charging the WeeBill 3S or power an extra light, like the Zhiyun Molux G60 right here. For a run and gun documentary with a one man operation, having everything in one setup is very nice. Let me show you my one man gimbal lighting setup right now. First, mount and balance your camera on the WeeBill 3S. I mount my Zhiyun G60 light with a softbox right here at the end of the sling arm. There is a 1/4-inch hole right here. You can mount it with a mini ball head, but I like the Felcam F22 dual quick release magic arm right here. It raised my light even higher to get rid of the camera shadow. It is very easy to loosen up and reposition my light like so, and it is built on a quick release system, so I can replace it with my ambisonic microphone like right here, or my Portkeys PT6 monitor, the best budget monitor and light box out there. It's a shame I cannot power my camera or the light using the gimbal, which requires 60 watt input PD power. But if this works, it will remove even the Vlog battery here. So Zhiyun, if you are watching this video, please make this feature available. For now, we can mount a small Vlog battery like my Moment 99 Pro Mini V-mount battery right here. It has PT power that can fast charge anything. It is also the only V-mount battery I found on the internet that tell me how much filming time left before I need to swap a new battery. As you see right here, it can power my Canon R5C in 8K 60 frames per second filming mode for over 6 hours. And it is also so small it fit into my palm. If you are a wedding videographer or a on-location documentary filmmakers, this setup will last you all day. WeeBill 3S has no interchangeable battery, but it supports operation while charging with the 2-hour PD fast charging. So a small V-mount battery like this one can be perfect. It extends 6 more hours of filming time for the WeeBill 3S, which is more than enough. For Canon R5C that need PD power and you also want to power a light simultaneously, I would recommend Bungo Tie a Shirgit Cyberpunk power brick on a sling arm like so. This allows 2 PD power output at the same time, and it is the most reliable battery to power PD support cinema camera, highly recommended. I will put all the links to the riggings and the battery option down below. As a professional filmmaker, I battle tested all my gears. I want to make this review video very useful and very practical for you. If you appreciate my extra effort, don't forget to subscribe and help us out. Follow me on Instagram as well, as I have more short rigging tips like this over there. We also recently used the new WeeBill 3S on our virtual tour job in Vancouver, Canada. 3D Vista now support VR 180 video in their virtual tour software. I walked the Cherry Blossom neighborhood with this exact setup to capture what it is like if you buy a house here and walk around the neighborhood. This really helps sell the properties. So, which gimbal is best for the virtual tour job? Well, I will say the Crane M3S. First, Crane M3S can perfectly support the Canon with the dual fisheye lens right here, make it the official smallest gimbal to support the professional level VR180 camera. It also have the same powerful field light as the WeeBill 3S. 1000 lux is very bright for most situations. But the most important feature of all that you probably only hear from this review video is the ability to capture full 360 immersive photo for virtual tour. This makes the Crane M2S the only tool you need to bring on any virtual tour video slash photo job. Let me show you how. We are going to use my Sony Alpha 1 with the TT Artisan 7.5mm fisheye lens as the camera setup right here. If you want to know why this is the most affordable and best lightweight virtual tour rig, check out this video right here. It is straightforward to connect the Canon EOS camera using the Bluetooth with the Crane M3S, but it is turned out to be a pretty confusing when I try to connect the Sony camera with it. So, if you are having the same issue like me, I hope this part of the tutorial will help you. First, you need to turn off your smartphone connect. Go to the globe icon right here, smartphone connect, smartphone connection set to off. Then, go into Bluetooth, set the Bluetooth function to on, pairing and set the Sony in pairing mode. On your gimbal touchscreen right here, go to settings, BLE shutter, you should see your camera right here. If not, restart your gimbal and try again while your camera is in the pairing mode. Now you can go back and you should see the Bluetooth icon. Hit the trigger button on the gimbal, nothing happened. Don't panic. Go back to the globe icon on your camera, under menu, select number 2, transfer remote, under Bluetooth remote control, turn it on. Now you should see the trigger icon next to your Bluetooth icon. Half press the gimbal trigger button will focus, and full press will take the photo. Great! Now put your Zhiyun Crane M3S on a tripod, like my Uni-Z travel tripod right here with a very small footprint. Make sure the gimbal is reset to the starting position. If not, double tap the trigger button to reset. Go to settings, advanced feature, select panorama, then to customize, horizontal, scroll down to 180 degrees, vertical, scroll down to the max value. The current firmware is 50 degrees. Hit next. Now, horizontally, you pick 4 photos. Usually for a fisheye lens, it is more than enough. But if you are using a regular lens, then increase this number until you get a 40% overlap between each photo. Vertical, 2 is enough. Hit next, and this is your setup. Click start and the gimbal will pan to capture full 180 photo on its own. When it's done, you triple tap the trigger button to pan the camera facing the LED screen direction like so. Repeat the above step to capture the other 180 side. Now, in post-production, you just bring in all the photo in PD GUI, do an auto stitch. Use a tempered stitch will usually get you a really good result. It is exactly the same as this tutorial, so you can follow along there. If Zhiyun is watching, I hope they can upgrade their mobile app to do a complete 360 turn. That will make the workflow even faster and better. Comment below to show your interest to the full 260 panorama feature so Zhiyun can update the feature for us. I do personally really enjoy the WeeBill 3S gimbal right here, and I think the Gen 10 stabilization system is pretty powerful. It is a great gimbal for everyday creators. And do you know what is better than a great gimbal? A free one! I bought 2 for a recent VR warranty job, and now I'm giving away one of them. Here's how you get a chance to win the gimbal. First, make sure you follow me on YouTube here and also on Instagram at hugh.ho. Comment and tell me a reason why you will need this gimbal. What features I mentioned in this video attract you, and tell me how this gimbal will make you a better content creator. Then I will pick the best answer and to give away the WeeBill 3S. Yes, it's not that easy. You need to sell me the reason why. Hey, if you like the content and think you gained some useful knowledge out of this, it will help me out a lot if you consider subscribing, give this video a big thumb up, and share this video on your social network. We really want to help you cut through the noise as a filmmaker or a content creator using the latest technology in AI and XR. We will challenge you to think outside of the box, the video box, how you can enlarge your frame and immerse your audience with stable footage, of course. Until next time, stay creative, my friends.